Hey everybody, welcome to videos Nathan really wanted to make but couldn't figure out how to categorize that I'm just apparently calling vlogging camp because it was the first thing that popped into my head. Avengers Endgame should win an Oscar for Best Picture. No, this is not clickbait. No, this is not fanboying out. I actually have a case to be made. And I want to make it clear that this is actually a spoiler-free video. I don't have to tell you anything that happens in the movie to make this case. My personal impression of the film is I enjoyed it very much. I would not say it was a perfect film, but it did a lot right. So much right. Which is pretty impressive when you consider how big the MCU is, how many movies there have been, how many years this has gone over. Being able to find satisfying conclusions to so many character arcs. Yeah, it's kind of mind-boggling that it was possible at all, in any capacity, to make that happen. Really makes me nervous for the end of Game of Thrones now. Oh boy. Not only do I want to explain why it should win for Best Picture, I want to tell you why it potentially could win. The first reason is actually precedent. You know, when the Academy Awards started back in 1929, they wanted to really show a very bright positive side. It was essentially a PR campaign for the motion picture industry. They really liked the idea of being able to have, like, their biggest stars get into nice dresses and nice suits and to sit down and award the best accomplishments that they had for the year. You know, a lot of early awards were given to dramas, like you might imagine, but, you know, musicals and those big epics that they used to have, well, they would get nominations as well, but tastes changed over each decade. More recently, the trend has been toward, you know, movies that really said that they were Oscar movies, you know, really telegraph that up at the front, you know, well, we're small and we're independent and you've probably never heard of this movie. Congratulations, you're in Oscar contention. But that has been changing because, again, the market has been changing. So you've seen more nominations for superhero movies and for fantasy films. That brings us to our current year where another MCU movie actually got nominated for Best Picture, Black Panther. And regardless of whether you think that that was deserved or not, the point is, it is an MCU film that was nominated for Best Picture, which means that another MCU film could also get nominated. Also, just on a quick segue, I never really understood when people were like, well, that doesn't seem like an Oscar movie, that doesn't seem like an Oscar movie. For me, an Oscar movie is a movie that gets nominated for an Oscar. That's really the only criteria I think of. Because there's been such a large swath of different genres that have at one point in time been nominated, but that's beside the point. The precedent is that the Academy has been saying, slowly but surely, that these are the kind of movies that are going to get more acknowledgement, going to be getting more attention, and that it would be good to nominate them. One of the reasons is because of the ratings that the Oscars have been receiving, which I guess is actually point two, if we're making an ordered list. One is because a lot of people stream live events now. It's the same reason why a lot of sporting events are not getting as high a rating system as they used to. But another reason that's usually cited is that the movies that are being nominated are not really movies that people have heard of. And it would be really great if we had movies that people have heard of at these ceremonies. So, from a PR standpoint, which again is the whole reason the Academy Awards was started, having Endgame up for Best Picture and then awarding it to them, that would be huge. And it would be huge for the Academy. It would definitely say to people that were watching, the average Joe on the street, that the ceremony is different now, and they have understood that the market has changed. But those are really not the big reason why I think that not only should it win, but it could actually win. In order to do that, I need to go back a few years to another epic that was called The Lord of the Rings. When Peter Jackson came to New Line Cinema and was like, I want to make the Lord of the Rings trilogy, surprisingly enough, they were like, yeah, here's a bunch of money, go to New Zealand and shoot it. And he went there, and he shot it. And for the most part, people were surprised you could even do that. There were a lot of, like, rumblings in Hollywood that they could never really make Lord of the Rings. And then Jackson Jackson went and did it, and did it very well. All three of those movies were nominated for Best Picture in the years that they were released, those three consecutive years. But the one movie that actually won for Best Picture was the last installment, Return of the King. Now, would I say that Return of the King was the best out of the trilogy? No, actually, I would say it was the weakest entry. There was a lot of heavy lifting they had to do in Fellowship and in Two Towers in order to do world building and character development, and they did a great job at that. The set pieces alone were pretty stunning in Two Towers. Return of the King, a lot of it was wrapping up, you know, trying to find some kind of satisfying conclusion to all of those storylines. About 17 satisfying conclusions, am I right? And yet, even though I don't think it was the best entry in that trilogy, I also think that it was the one that absolutely deserved an Oscar if one out of the three movies was going to receive it. Because it wasn't just getting an Oscar for itself. It was getting an Oscar for the entire trilogy. And more importantly, for the accomplishment. And see, that's really the big point that I wanted to make. Number three, I guess, on our list is the accomplishment. I want to remind everybody that Endgame isn't just Endgame. It is also the 22nd movie in 12 years that is part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And again, when the original Iron Man came out, there were a lot of people that were going, well, this is an impossible task for you to pull off. Marvel Studios was convinced that they could do this. They were really committed to being able to create a cinematic universe, which was nigh on unheard of at the time. Not only did they come out of the gates swinging, but year after year after year, they produced really good films. They weren't all gems, but their hit ratio was pretty good. And somehow, with all of these disparate characters that run the gambit of all sorts of planets through time and space, somehow comes to a satisfying conclusion at the end of all of that with Endgame. This is the first time in cinematic history that that has been pulled off successfully. Actually, it's like the first time it's ever even been attempted. And Marvel did it beautifully. That says so much about the industry and where the industry can go from here. And I personally think that that is very deserving of an award, not just for the movie, but for the accomplishment. This is why I said I don't really have to spoil Endgame. All I have to tell you is that I feel, as a lot of people have, that it is a satisfying conclusion to this giant arc that they set up in the cinematic universe to this point. Because that's really what is worthy of an award. It means a lot to Hollywood, too. To the motion picture industry, it means that Marvel has successfully shown that you can do this. No one knew that you could before, and they proved that it is possible, and that you can pull it off effectively. People have been floating around some of the actors as well to receive awards for their performances in Endgame, and again, I think that if they get those nominations and get those awards, it is very well deserved, but it won't just be for what they did in Endgame. It will be for what their characters have done over multiple movies up to this point. I mean, while I'm throwing it out there, I think the Russo brothers should be getting Best Director. Do you understand how hard it must have been to try and take all of these properties that were helmed by a ton of different people, written by a ton of different people, with all of these different branches of the Marvel Universe, and try and bring them together as one cohesive package? I mean, between Infinity War and Endgame, that task seems monumental. It seems almost impossible. And yet, they did a really good job. It's impressive work. It just is. And then finally, apparently number four, if we're listing these out, I don't even know how many numbers I was planning on having. Money! Sometimes films just make so much money that they have to receive some kind of acknowledgement. I mean, look at, you know, Avatar, for instance. Was Avatar a brilliant movie story-wise? Not really, but again, the technical accomplishment that they made, especially because James Cameron had really started the 3D camera system that we now see in all big budget movies today. That's part of it, but it's also because it made a ton of money. Titanic, same thing. Sometimes movies just make so much money, ducats, that they have to be acknowledged because everyone's seen them, and again, that means that there are going to be a lot of eyes on it, that it's hard not to at least acknowledge that they exist. Granted, Avatar didn't win for Best Picture, but it was in tight competition that year. All things considered, I actually would not be surprised if next year, you know, during Oscar season, they started talking about Endgame being nominated and even winning an award. And you have to imagine what kind of an epic moment that would be for the Oscars. How many still shots there would be of the entire MCU cast and crew standing up on the dais to receive an award. That's just a gigantic photo op. People would have a completely new viewpoint of the Oscars, which, you know, a lot of folks out there have started to feel was kind of insular and, you know, maybe a little too haughty. That's kind of like a win-win all around. I mean, it's not like Disney doesn't have the money to promote it. I mean, if anybody can, it's gonna be them. And why wouldn't they want to? And I know what a lot of people are probably thinking at this point. Nathan, you can't just call the Oscars. There's a lot of the year left. Look, I understand that there's a lot of movies left to come out. And you know what? A lot of them might be brilliant. I understand that. But the problem is that not a single one of them is going to be the conclusion to 12 years and 22 films worth of backstory. Not a single one of them. If there was anything that was even comparable, I might accept that argument. I mean, even if you look at Star Wars, you know, with Episode 9 coming out later this year, even if that's great, even if they pull that off, yeah, maybe it's worthy of a nomination, maybe it's worthy of acclaim if they do a good job with it, but still, there was never really a point where, from the beginning of Star Wars history, we said, this is going to be a cinematic universe. Now, that kind of came later, and they did individual trilogies that could potentially stand on their own. I'm talking about this massive cinematic universe that was set up as a cinematic universe from the beginning. That just has never happened before. It is a monumental achievement in filmmaking. And that's what I think really should get honored. Because if they don't bother to honor that, then it's gonna seem like a huge missed opportunity. This is the first time that that has been pulled off. And pulled off with overall success. And it should speak volumes for the future of filmmaking. And that alone should be worthy of an Oscar. All right, everybody, thank you for joining me on what I guess I'm calling vlogging camp to make the case for things, just stuff that happens to fall into my head that I want to make videos on. It's fun. We'll see what the next vlogging camp is. Might be about Sonic. There's a whole thing I want to do on that. Yeah, I got thoughts. Anyway, if I ever do this again, hopefully you'll join me. But until then, as I usually say in these videos where I'm standing and talking directly into a camera, don't forget to dislike and unsubscribe. I'm setting up my own, like, YouTube cinematic universe, and so I want this to be one of the threads that just pays off at the end. I don't really know what that payoff is going to be. It's gonna have lasers. That's all you really need to know, so get ready for that.